Good morning, students. In my previous video on comprehension, I have told you about its meaning, definition, and importance. I have also explained you that a proper understanding of the passage and the questions given with it is very necessary for comprehension. And now you also know that the questions asked from the comprehension passage are of different types. They can be direct questions or indirect questions, vocabulary-based questions, and inference-based questions. So till here we have already discussed. Now for today, I am going to tell you about as to how to answer these different types of questions. Students, if you proceed strategy-wise and follow some steps, you will be able to answer all the questions correctly. So this is how it goes. First of all, scan the text. This means you have to read the passage, but initially read only the first 4-5 lines carefully, and with that the theme of the passage will be clear to you. Like you'll get an idea about it as whether it's a part of a story, an article about environment, something about culture or history or economics. Means you'll get an idea about the subject of the passage. Read again, this time thoroughly with full concentration so as to know the details. Read the questions carefully. Understand what is asked. Don't get confused and be clear in your mind. Now, take up the direct questions first and find out to which parts of the passage it refers. Turn to the relevant portions of the passage, read them again, and rewrite them in your own language clearly and concisely. Remember, while framing the answers, don't pick up the exact sentences from the passage. Your answer should be brief and to the point, and should be in your own words. Okay, right? Then after you have solved the direct questions from the passage, it's time for you to solve the indirect questions based on understanding of the paragraph. If you are asked to find out the title of the passage or the main theme, you can easily find it either in the opening or in the concluding lines of the passage. Heading to the passage can also be given after the main character if there is any object or incident mentioned in the passage, or after some saying or proverb illustrated in the passage. You must also know how to write a title, and for that keep in mind that except articles, prepositions and connectives, all the other words of the title should begin with capital letters. If you are asked to give the meaning of any word, phrase or expression or antonym and synonym given in italics or bold, sometimes it is underlined also, do it carefully, keeping the central idea of the passage in the mind. You can try to grasp their meaning from the context in which they are used and express them in simple language. I repeat, do it carefully, keeping the central idea of the passage in the mind. If you have the central idea of the passage in your mind, you can grasp their meaning of those words or those synonyms and antonyms. It will be helpful in that. And from the context in which they are used, you can express them in simple language. Then, if you have time, revise your answers and examine them carefully to ensure that they are in conformity with the spirit and requirement of the questions asked. So students, you can follow these steps while attempting the comprehension exercise and can answer the questions in an easy and expressive way. But before leaving this video, I would like to share two more important tips with you. Number one is avoid regressive reading. Avoid regressive reading. You should learn to read a comprehension passage. There are certain things essential for reading comprehension, like fluency is very important. Your vocabulary should be strong. Understanding is the most important attribute. And then decoding of the text. In exam time, budgeting is very important. So try to develop the skill of reading comprehension. If you are skillful in reading comprehension, it will help and support you in answering the questions, and you will be able to save time. Students, there is one more method which can save your time in exams. It is the other way around. I mean to say that instead of reading the passage first, you can read the questions. I repeat, instead of reading the passage first, you can read the questions. Try to retain the questions in your mind and then read the passage. Underline the keywords you came across in the questions. Stop and solve the direct questions then and there only. Meanwhile, you can underline the important facts and make points which will help you while answering the understanding-based questions, that is, your indirect questions. Then second important thing which I want to tell you is that don't give your personal opinion in the answers. I mean to say that suppose the passage is about, say, environment or, for example, social evils, then as a person, as an individual, as a student, you have some knowledge about these topics. You have your own views regarding these topics. But while framing answers for the questions based on the passage, stick to the source text. Remember, stick to the source text, to the original text. That is, give answers based on the content of the passage only, even if the passage contains erroneous data or unusual opinion on some common subject, and you are sure that the author's opinion is quite contrary to the general opinion on that subject. Okay, right? And then, of course, last but not the least, some practice is required in reading comprehension. As we all know, that practice makes a man perfect. Although to achieve perfection is something not easy, but at least you can achieve excellence in reading comprehension by practicing and following the strategy that I have shared with you to help you solve the comprehension exercise. And now, I am leaving. See you soon. Till then, keep practicing. Thank you.